Dozens of Filipinos trapped by military clashes in Sudan are calling on the Philippine government to bring them home. Some of them say they failed to join repatriation efforts last May due to lack of funds to pay for transportation to go to the Egyptian border. There are also at least 17 Filipinos stranded at the port of Sudan for nearly 2 weeks now. Some of them are getting sick.
Kalina na rin po ako ng dugo kaya hindi ako nakapag-decide noon ng buya dahil kasi nahihiyo ako. Hindi ko kaya magbiyahe ng malayo.
Humingi na rin po ako ng tulong sa embassy ng Cairo. Ang dami po nilang hinahanap. Certificate po, passport. E wala naman po ako may pakita dahil sa gera.
The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department says it is working on the repatriation. It estimates around 200 Filipinos are still in the conflict-hit nation. More than 500,000 Maynilad customers will experience 9-hour water interruption starting next week after the Angat Dam's water level dropped further. Jervis Manahan with the details.
Photos taken by ABS-CBN News show the receding level of water in the Angat Dam. This Friday, its water level dropped further to 180.45 meters above sea level. Pag-asa projects Angat's water level to hit minimum operating level this Sunday.
Kailangan natin ng at least 1,350 millimeters of rainfall, katumbas ng mga 4-5 bagyo, para mapuno yung Angat Dam. Worst case scenario, just in case na wala talagang mga pag-ulan within the watershed, posibleng umabot ito ng 165. So, near critical elevation yon, 160 yung critical elevation natin. So, pag umabot tayo doon, medyo alanganin na. Medyo delikado na talaga, pila balde.
The National Water Resources Board is hoping Angat Dam will not reach its lowest recorded level of 157 meters, which happened in July 2010.
Hindi po natin sasabihin komportable tayo sa ngayon. At kukumpara natin sa mga naunang mga taon, medyo mas mataas pa yun. But sabi nga natin, napaka-importante po itong kasalukuyang mga susunod na buwan kung ano po yung magiging sitwasyon doon sa pag-recharge ng mga dam natin.
The water regulator says water allocation for both domestic use and irrigation could be reduced either by Sunday or Monday. The MWSS advised Maynilad customers will start experiencing service interruptions starting next Wednesday. More than 500,000 customers will be affected by the disruption that will last for as long as 9 hours.
We are managing muna yung supply and we expect at the earliest there will be an interruption on Wednesday. But that's the earliest, pero yung in-expect po natin, by Friday po yung interruption. So Maynilad will be issuing notice of interruption to the customers on Monday.
The concessionaires are also discussing the possibility of lowering water pressure to conserve water. Manila Water customers will not be affected.
Nawawalan po kami ng tubig, hindi kami naaabisuhan. Tapos, may nakukuhaan naman po kami ng tubig doon po sa kamag-anak namin, pero magbabayad.
Maaga maglalaba, tapos maaga magsisiligo.
The Environment Department also issued Memorandum Circular 22, which mandates government offices to conserve water. Main water valves have to be turned off starting 7 p.m. to 6 a.m. of the next day. The memorandum also calls for government offices to install separate water meters. Jervis Manahan, ABS-CBN News.
YouTube bans the channels of the church and media network led by controversial Philippine televangelist Apollo Quiboloy. The channels of the SMNI network and the Kingdom of Jesus Christ Church were taken down for violations of YouTube's terms of service. YouTube's parent firm Google cited compliance with applicable U.S. sanctions laws as the basis for the ban. Quiboloy is charged in the U.S. with sex trafficking and is on the FBI's wanted list. His personal YouTube channel was first taken down on June 21st after a game vlogger questioned why the pastor was still allowed on the video sharing platform. SMNI has yet to respond to ANC's request for a comment. Philippine Tourism Secretary Cristina Frasco still enjoys the trust and confidence of President Marcos. This despite a bungled campaign video for their new tourism slogan, Love the Philippines. The president said he hailed Frasco's move to immediately terminate the contract of the ad agency, which used stock footage of other countries in producing the widely criticized video.
Sa aking palagay, she has it under control. She knows what to do, and what she has done so far inspires confidence that she will fix the problem, and that the campaign of Love Philippines will be as successful as we hope for it to be.
The Philippine National Bureau of Investigation apologizes for having sexy dancers at its socials night last week. NBI Director Medardo De Lemos vows to investigate the matter, but he insists no public funds were spent for the event, which he claims was paid for by NBI agents themselves. The NBI chief also claims he was unaware that sexy dancers were part of the entertainment since he left the event early.
Una sa lahat, humihingi kami ng paumanhin dahil sa hindi namin intensyon na makasakit ng damdamin ng ating kababaihan. Kung naging offensive man sa sensibilities ng ating mamamayan, humihingi po kami ng paumanhin. Pinapaimbestigahan natin ang pangyayari kung sino ang nag-imbita, nagdala ng dancer, at kung sino ang nagpahintulot na mag-perform sila doon sa NBI socials. Aalamin natin kung sino ang may dapat managot sa pagkakamali na ito. We'll never tolerate indecency in the agency.
Former Philippine Senator Laila De Lima dismayed with the inhibition of yet another judge handling her last drug case. In a statement, De Lima said she respects Judge Abraham Joseph Alcantara's decision but slammed the prosecution for asking for the inhibition. De Lima insisted Alcantara's earlier ruling was consistent with the law, evidence, and reason, unlike with the case of the previous handling judge who supposedly had a conflict of interest. The detained former senator added, inhibitions are meant to assure the accused and not the government that the trial will be fair. De Lima's lawyer had called the development nothing but another delaying tactic of the Justice Department. The case is slated to be raffled off on Monday. President Marcos says his administration is working on making the country more investor-friendly to further promote employment. Marcos made that statement as he hailed the May jobs report, which showed the country's unemployment and underemployment rates both eased in May. Marcos says his government will continue to prioritize revitalizing the economy so Filipinos can have better access to quality jobs.
Nakakatuwa naman at dahan-dahan ay umaakyat yung numero ng employed dito sa Pilipinas. Ang punot dulo nitong lahat ay trabaho talaga. Kailangan magkaroon ng economic activity para magkaroon ng trabaho ang ating mga kababayan.
The Philippine Nuclear Research Institute says Japan's plan to release radioactive water into the ocean is relatively harmless. According to PNRI Director Carlo Arcilla, it's not right to say that the water is contaminated since it has been treated. He adds radiation possibly left in the water is very weak and is something that could not even penetrate the skin and has no effect on marine life. The assurance comes after China raised concerns over Japan's plan to discharge more than 1 million metric tons of treated water from the tsunami-wrecked Fukushima nuclear plant. But the UN's nuclear watchdog said the plan meets international standards.
The IAEA's committee that measured this comprised scientists from different countries and their independent laboratories. And I have seen the labs and the quality of work that the IAEA has done. And I am personally convinced of the safety and also the consistency. We're lucky actually that Japan is in here because they are very compliant.